Everyone dies. And when it's our time to go, some of us will be embalmed, buried, some cremated. But there's a place where our bodies still tell stories long after death. And it's in our own backyard. This week, we take you to the Body Farm.
We are continuing our series on the Forensic Anthropology Center.
And so far this week, we've given you the history and taken you to their 3-acre research site. But the science doesn't stop there.
That's right. Tonight, we follow the bones after they leave the Body Farm. A warning, some of this content may be sensitive to some of our viewers.
Every day we work with the body donation program where we are answering questions from potential donors, bringing in donors who have passed away.
The moment a donor arrives at the Forensic Anthropology Center, the research begins.
There's not a day when someone's not out there taking a photo, doing research. We have a database of over a million photos of donors throughout decomposition.
So when we receive a donor, depending on the research that they're enrolled in, they're typically out at the facility for a year to 2 years.
After the decomposition process is complete here, the donor's skeletal remains are recovered and brought to the Bass Forensic Anthropology Building to be cleaned by students.
They're going to clean off the dirt, make them safe to handle with bare hands. They will use dental picks and brushes over the sink with just water. We can get a skeleton done in an afternoon if it's just a little bit dirty.
It's a lab with hints of a home.
Crockpots are what we use for small amounts of mummified tissue and cartilage. So when we have really stubborn tissue that is not coming off, we just heat the water up so that it's not boiling, just so that it's warm, and that causes that tissue to loosen up so that it can then be scraped off with a dental pick or just pulled off with forceps. After they are finished cleaning, they'll put the tray on the clean rack and we'll do an inventory at the end once the entire donor has been finished being cleaned.
Next, those bones make their way to Strong Hall, where they are cataloged and labeled and kept forever inside the Bass Skeletal Collection.
We have received over 2,000 donors since 1981, when Dr. Bass first initiated the body donation program.
But those thousands of bones aren't sitting collecting dust on the shelf.
We like to believe there's no end to the gift of body donation here because we use the skeletons from 1981 today for research and for training. And we have people come from all over the world to take part in that.
One current research project will help law enforcement better interpret fire deaths.
Many times we'll get a case of people who die in fires in residences, and the police have to ask the question, did they die in the fire or did something happen to them before? And it can be very, very difficult to tell that because the fire itself creates so much fragmentation of the body. So we can see lots of broken bones, but we can't necessarily tell, did those happen before the fire or as a result of the fire? And that's going to be a game changer with how we interpret fire deaths.
Another study shows how our body's decomposition is affected by medication.
And that's looking at the drugs that an individual has on board at death, and then how long can those be detected after death? Does that impact or affect scavenging activity? Does it impact insect activity?
Anthropologists aren't the only ones who are privy to the research.
Families can come and sit with remains or learn what we've learned about them.
Families do continue to call and they want to know what projects their loved one has been incorporated into. They may want to know step by step what happened, you know, from the time we received the donor, the body, what do we do with it? And then, you know, we talk about it. They may want to see what's in the files.
The donors that donate their bodies, we could not do it without them. It is the greatest gift in the world to donate your body to science because it helps endless people.
The end of one life that can give an eternal gift in the name of science. In Knoxville, Leslie Ackerson.
And tomorrow, we will complete our series on the Body Farm by explaining the process of how you become a donor. We will hear from one woman who said the choice for her was easy.
And you can watch the first 3 parts of our series and read more about the Body Farm right now at WBIR.com.